I know, I'm freaking out because I feel like you're about to like change my life.
Well, your brother, you said your brother is a big flat earther. You guys work together, and you're not a flat earther. How
I'm
much
not.
have you looked into it?
I barely touched into it because I wanted to kind of familiarize myself with who you are and your work before I actually sit down and talk to you so I don't end up probably asking. I'll probably do
So
it anyway, but yeah.
you're a flat earther. If you looked into me. And there are no new questions. There's only old questions. So you're going to ask every question that I've already answered.
No, exactly. That's exactly why I wanted to kind of skim myself over your work, is because I didn't want to be repeating questions. Because for some reason, even though I know the gist of it, I'm still not convinced.
All right. Well, let's find out why you think you live on a spinning ball, flying through an infinite crazy gas impossible gas vacant vacuum.
Okay, so the first thing would be
Before you ask, this is where I live. This is where I know that we live, and this is where you think you live, okay? Just so you know, because most people don't even realize that they think this, all right? So just think of this. The Earth is one of these little dots here. It's spinning at 1,000 miles an hour. Okay.
That's what they say. You're moving so fast. That's what's keeping you to the earth, right?
Well, no, that would throw you off the Earth. They're saying the magic of gravity
Yeah,
keeps you on the Earth. You're orbiting, that's the spiral that's going around the sun at 66,000 miles an hour. Just let me show you this. Watch this. This is the hypersonic sled. It goes by a Mach 8.6. Ready? It's gone. Okay. We're orbiting 10 times faster than that. 10 times faster than this.
okay.
Okay? Does that make any sense to you?
Yeah.
It doesn't, it does make sense to you?
So we're just orbiting so fast that.
We're orbiting so fast, and then we're also chasing the sun at 90 times as fast as this. You can't even fathom that, but we have lakes that kind of look like they're sitting still. Like there's nothing moving. When we're done, I want you to get a dinner plate, fill it with water, and try to walk across the house with it, okay? All right, we're flat,
It's
we're
just left.
level, we're stationary, and water proves this. All right, go ahead, your turn.
So isn't gravity the thing that keeps everything together?
So that is their magic gravity. So if you
You don't believe in gra that gravity is real, right?
Well, so if I told you that I'm the king of, I don't know, some continent, would you believe me? Because that's how much evidence they have. I can produce more evidence that I'm a king of a continent than they can produce for gravity. Gravity's just a theory. Neil deGrasse Tyson, the high priest of scientism, when he was recently asked about what is gravity, he goes, "I don't know." He goes, "I don't know." And to make gravity work, they have to come up with dark matter and dark energy. Have you heard of that? Dark matter and dark, they say space is 96%, 96%. That means 4% is regular gravity. 96% is something that they've never seen, they've never measured, and there's no evidence of it, but it has to exist for gravity to work. So therefore, it exists because they came up with a theory that doesn't work without a magical 96% of nonsense.
Okay.
Okay,
So
so.
that gravity is just like a cover for that just doesn't exist. That's just something they came up with
It
so that we would believe.
gravity is the big their god for the heliocentric ball universe because
Right.
gravity all of a sudden pulled all the rocky bits together after the Big Bang, and then it also somehow got all the gases to pull into burning balls and left a vacuum in between. A vacuum, nature abhors a vacuum. No, there's no natural vacuums anywhere. Gas spreads out into fill all low pressure systems. All right, so how do we have burning balls of gas in a vacuum? That's just scientifically impossible, but it's all complete and total nonsense that they've brainwashed us into believing for no reason. Things fall down. Or how about this? This is my forward. Well, your forward is kind of, if we're facing each other, is a different direction. Your forward's my backwards, your backwards my forwards. My left is your right, my right is your left. Okay? But you're up, point up, is the same up as mine, and you're down. Point down. Point down is the same down as mine. Somebody in Australia, down is down for them. Down is
Right.
not up.
I know.
Down is not up. We live on a level plane with hills and valleys. Water proves that it's level because water shows us the level. We use water as a level. Okay? And down is down, up is up. Density and buoyancy. If you got a basketball, will it go to the bottom of a swimming pool? No, it won't, because the water is more dense than the basketball. But will it fall through the air? Yes, it will, because it's more dense than the air. Will a helium balloon fall to the earth? Nope, it'll go up because it's less dense than the atmosphere around it. Buoyancy and density sort everything else out. Now, there's a lot of people that say that's all that there is. But there's a lot of us that say, you know what? There has to be something more. There has to be some sort of, hey, down is this way. It's something that has to indicate down is this way, because imagine if the earth disappeared. A lot of people have a problem with that. You can't, well, the earth doesn't disappear. Well, if the earth wasn't here, which way would down be? And the answer is earth has a negative charge to it. And if you understand everything in this world, the only true forces are electricity and magnetism. Well, there's electricity everywhere and it's flowing like a river to the Earth's negative charge. So there's an invisible flow of electricity, and that's the down direction. Everything that has a charge to it, everything has a charge, says down is this way. And we can manipulate how heavy things are by changing the charge in them. Like we add more negative ion electrons to something, it gets heavier. That doesn't make sense with gravity, but it makes sense in an electromagnetic buoyancy and density world where we live.
Something that my brother had said, because I have things I already want to say, but that would be jumping too much forward.
Go.
Something my brother had said was like, how would it make sense, like if gravity was real, for a butterfly to fly? Or a balloon, like you just said, to float.
Or think about this. Oceans weigh, I don't know how much they weigh, hundreds of trillions of tons, just an imaginable weight. And but I can jump. I can jump off the earth. A butterfly can fly. When you watch rain, you know, if you've ever been in a flooding area where rain's coming down, there's rain, you know, and just fill up a bucket of water, how heavy that is. Well, that's only a tiny bit of what is coming down. Where was all that water? Was it just floating in the sky and gravity was ignoring it? Okay.
This is upsetting.
Well, here's the thing. Here's the thing. It's upsetting is the wrong word. It's it breaks everything that you've been indoctrinated with your entire life. Your entire world is wrapped around your belief system, and your belief system's wrapped around a ball, okay? Because you were taught the earth was a ball before you could speak, okay? You were taught the earth is a ball in all the children's programming, all the movies, everything you see, every class. The first worksheet you brought home from school was about the orbits of the planets and the moons and the sun. That's one of the first worksheets. Because then you build your life around that and you have disconnected yourself from the true world. You've short-circuited and you've imprisoned your mind in a ball, right? It's like Neo at the beginning of the Matrix. He's plugged into the system. He doesn't know what the world is. He unplugged. He took his power back. It was upsetting to Neo. Did you see the Matrix? Say yes. The movie The
No,
Matrix. You have not. So
I need to watch
this is your homework. You need to see it. So Neo's plugged into the Matrix. He doesn't know what the world is. By the end of the movie, he's unplugged. And when he gets unplugged, he gets very upset. I guess we can use that word. But then he sees the true power of his mind and how expansive the world is and how powerful we are. It's all about hiding our power. It's all about disconnecting us from the creator. And whoever the creator is to you, that's your own journey. It's not my journey. It's not my journey to know what your relationship with the creator is. And so that's what they want. They don't want you in a position, I'll show you, they are, don't want you in a position where you can't deny the creator. Because once you understand that we are at the center of creation and how powerful we are, and that there's more, and that there's not lack of anything other than these days common sense, then you take your power back and nobody has power over you. The only power anyone in this world has over you is in your imagination.
Maybe,
Who has
about
power over
that.
you? Who can make
Well,
you do something?
we can go off the rails with that one, but like, there's just bad energy out there, and there's lots of energy out there, and it's impossible to for that not to affect you, no matter how much you think you're in charge.
Well, true, because it gets to us and they work their way in and but it's all in your head. If you don't accept it, you know, I don't know, vampires, vampire movies. We all know about vampire movies and shows. Mm-hmm. Vampires always have to ask permission to come in, right? Evil has to ask permission to come in, right? And if you, and what they do is they're not, the way I see the world is they're not allowed to break our free will. And so by doing that, they can't trick us too badly. So they have to tell us what they're doing. They tell us all of the craziness that's happening. And then when we don't say no, it's kind of like inviting them in. It's the way the world works. So again, yeah, things can get you down. Things could, you know, I got to do this because, you know, I need to get this done. That's all in your mind. It's all in your mind.
Well, it's all like a rat race for money too. And I feel like that's and one of the
money is imaginary. The elite don't need money. They only use it to control us. So that's, you're really very good. There's two things that we need to free ourselves from tyranny. One is to get our heads out of our asses and put on our big boy pants and realize who we live and take our power back. The other one is stop playing with their control system, their monopoly money. You ever play the game Monopoly?
Yeah, I love them.
And it says, go read the instructions. It says, if the bank ever runs out of money, just get a pad of paper and write some more money on it and keep playing.
Right.
Okay. Well, it's that's great. What they do. They control us with this debt-based system. So we need to get off of that. We need to get onto privacy cryptocurrencies, not the government-run Bitcoin at this point, the corporate sellout coins, the coins that they cannot control.
Speaking of so-called sellouts, I have loved Elon Musk, and of course, Grimes is my favorite musician, producer. So I've been really into them for a while now. And I just recently watched Elon Musk had the SpaceX/NASA documentary out on Netflix. Did you watch that?
Do you know who Edward Bernays is? Edward Bernays is the king of propaganda. His grandson or son or whatever, his relative runs Netflix. Netflix is mind control. That I'm going to send you a video. You're actually going to get an automated email from me when we're done. And one of the things it says is Elon Musk fraud. And there's a link. It's a 5-minute video. It's going to ruin your day. Elon Musk is a fraud. Nothing he has ever said is true. He's lied about everything. And he's not a trillionaire, a billionaire, or any of that. He's a puppet. And he doesn't do any of the things that he says. It's called Elon Musk Exposed. It's on a million channels, but you'll have the link. And I invite you to share it in the description of wherever you post this so people can see it. Elon Musk is a fraud beyond frauds.
Did he ever start out good? Or
no,
is this
nothing. He was born to a very rich family. He claimed to being a kid with no money growing up poor, but he was selling emeralds on the street. His parents had like an emerald trading company and all of the stuff. Every company he's built loses money. He got fired. He didn't start PayPal. He didn't start Tesla Motors. It's all nonsense. And once you see it, you can't unsee it. I mean, do you remember when he sent his Tesla Roadster into space? Did you see that?
Yes.
Did you actually look at it? Did you actually look at it?
Yes.
And does it look real to you?
He even talked about it.
Did you see that little glitch? Yeah, but you're listening to Joe Rogan, another complete and total sellout. Right? This is done in a soundstage. There's no car floating in space. Okay, I used to love Elon Musk and Joe Rogan, and then I woke up, okay? I'll admit it. It hurts to even say that. Joe Rogan sold out for $100 million, and he said in a quote, he would even lie to his mother. Joe Rogan was the poster boy for exposing the moon fraud. You know, he's like, there is no way we went to the moon. Look at this piece of crap, okay? He's like, there's no way. There's nothing you could say to me ever that would get me to believe that we went to the moon. There's no way. Then he had Neil deGrasse Tyson on his show. He took a little vacation, came back, had a new network's television show, huge contract. His podcast took off, and he goes, oh, yeah, we didn't go to the moon. He just totally sold out. Clearer than anything, okay? There's no clearer show of a sellout than Joe Rogan. Here's his quote. There is no way people went on the moon. There's no way. Then there's no way there was a ho there was a
He's
hoax. There's
wearing
no
a
way.
NASA
What's that? Say that again.
wearing a NASA costume.
Yeah, because he totally sold out. He had Neil deGrasse Tyson on, and then he got big contracts, money. He just got his $100 million contract. This guy, now let me tell you something. He says some good stuff, but he also is pandering to the agenda. He is, he's doing all sorts of crazy stuff. Owen Benjamin just today, the day of this recording, just did a segment on him on how insane the guy is. The guy's super powerful right now because he has so many followers and people that just believe him. And he's a liar. He's a liar. So,
I
so far,
do.
so far, I've partially taken your ball away. I've taken your hero, Elon Musk, away. I've smashed Joe the Toe Rogan. Do you know that he's only 3 inches tall? Did you know that? Joe Rogan is only
That Joe Rogan
three,
is three
he's only
inches tall.
3 inches tall. Okay? It's
Don't know
called a
about that.
Rogan. Go Google the Joe Rogan Rogan measurement or something like that. There's a website that you can calculate how many Rogans tall you are. Rogan is
So
a measure. It's a measure. It's a Joe. Ahead.
I don't want to make this all about how heartbroken I am that all my heroes are, possibly who
Well,
I've
know
who.
your new heroes can be your brother. Okay, your brother is a hero.
Yeah, he's an amazing person for
He's a
sure.
hero.
Yeah, he's an angel.
And Alex Stein, another hero. Who's Alex Stein?
People say that I'm not going to say that I'm included in this yet because I don't think I am 100% yet. I'm open to it, but I'm not there yet. But people say that people that are believers in all of this are dangerous. And there have been a handful of people that are very upset that I'm talking to you.
Oh, so there's so on the news they're equating anti-vaxxers and terrorists with flat earthers, and they're desperately flatten the curve. That's a poke at flat earth, okay? Because they know, yeah, we are super dangerous. Let me tell you how dangerous flat earthers are. We could take down the entire bullshit structure control system that they have if we expose flat earth. If everyone woke up to flat earth today, all governments, all universities, all religious houses of worship would be shut down the next day, okay? And the whole world would go into turmoil. Well, guess what? We're already going into turmoil, but we're going into a turmoil of slavery because people don't know who they are, where they are, what they are. Their heads are in their asses and they're spinning out of control, lost in space. That's crazy. That's crazy.
I'm interested to hear what you think is going to happen. But first of all, I do want to ask you, do you think that the moon and the sun are flat?
So that's a it's kind of a straw man argument. First of all, the moon kind of looks spherical to me. Doesn't it look spherical to you? I'm going to show you four moons quickly. Tell me if which one's a sphere. Is that a sphere? Quick. Quick. Okay. Well, it's a half a sphere. It kind of tricked you. How about this one? Is this one a sphere?
Yeah, it looks like a sphere.
It looks like a sphere. I agree. That one probably looks most like a sphere. Unfortunately, it's flat. Okay.
Yeah, it's
Is this one a
layered
sphere?
colors. I just want to say yes
Yeah, but
and
it's not.
no.
It's a bowl. So
Okay.
saying what shape something is that we see in the sky, sorry, it doesn't work. Okay? And here's the other thing. Do you have lights in your ceiling above you right now?
Over there.
Okay, look at your light. Stare at that light. Notice everything about it and tell me what shape your floor is. What shape is your floor based on that light?
I don't know.
It's a
It's just
ridiculous
flat.
question, right? It's a ridiculous question. Your floor is flat. I don't care if the light is a ball, a flat, triangular, a hexagon. It has nothing to do with the floor. But the moon, when it, the moon and its phases, first of all, let me say, the moon is probably the biggest mystery of all. Okay, nobody knows what the moon is, but when there's a new moon and it's not lit up, it's gone. Nobody can ever see it. Well, that's crazy. You should be able to see it with the from the space station, from Earth, with infrared during an eclipse. You should be able to see it, but no one's ever seen it, so it's not even there, which is crazy. But look how bright this is. Go out on a full moon night in the middle of nowhere where there's no other lights, and you can read a book by the moon. It'll cast your shadow on the ground. but you believe that this astral liar, this Actronaut, is standing on this dusty, dirty ball, and that's reflecting all the way back to Earth and looking this bright? Does that make any sense to you?
The reflection of it is something I never considered before.
Where are you located? What state are you in?
I'm in Illinois.
Okay, so is it clear? If it's clear tonight, when the moon is in the sky tonight, right next to the moon will be a really bright star. It'll be the brightest star in the sky, and that's Jupiter, what we call Jupiter. It used to be called a wandering star, right? And when you see Jupiter, you have to realize Jupiter is so much farther away from the sun than us. You know, the sun looks like a nickel held up at arm's length to us. Well, from Jupiter, it would look like a BB, maybe. It would be almost as small as a star. It'd be much smaller. So now you have to imagine you're on Jupiter, which is a gaseous planet, right? This is supposedly Jupiter. That's less reflective than the Earth or the moon would be. The sun is farther away and smaller. That little, small, far distant sun is lighting up Jupiter, and then it's reflecting back to Earth, and it's brighter than anything in the sky. Okay? Mm-hmm. Does that make any sense to you?
I don't know. It was hard to follow.
Well, so let's say your face is the Earth, and I'm standing 2 feet away from you with a flashlight, and I'm lighting up your face. Mm-hmm. Okay, your face has got some light on it. Now you're going to walk 500 yards away from me or 100 yards away from me, and I'm take that flashlight. Is it going to really light up your face very much in the dark?
No, not
really. Well, the sun is allegedly much farther away from Jupiter. It's lighting up Jupiter, and it's reflecting back, and it's brighter than any star in the sky. And here's the other thing. It's not your fault that your brain short circuits when I'm explaining that, because they never taught us to think in school. They only taught us to memorize and regurgitate.
Yeah, that's something I did talk to my brother about. It made me realize how little we actually learned about this in school. We were briefed over it as if it was some boring subject that we didn't care to learn anything about, and then it was never touched again.
100%.
So just to kind of backtrack a little, that documentary on SpaceX on Netflix that is, you know, newly on there, I did watch the entire docuseries.
Which one? What are we talking about? Oh, about space? Yeah.
Yeah. Don't remember what it's called.
I watched the first episode and I vomited and I couldn't watch anymore. It's such garbage.
So are you suggesting that these are all... So just for anyone who hasn't watched it, it is four regular members of society that were selected to go to space without being an actual astronaut.
Right. And once you look at the details of what's going on, they're just actors. They didn't go into space. Okay. It's just complete and total nonsense. And you remember just recently, Jeff Bezos supposedly went up into space, and Richard Branson. Okay. They're in what's called a zero-G plane. Right. They didn't go up, and no one goes up in a rocket, and they're just getting zero G time. Richard looks like he's about to throw up, but they always have the girl with the long hair. So you go, oh, look, it's weightless and whatnot. And this is they were supposedly floating for 4.5 minutes, but they only show us like 5 seconds at a time. OK. Right. This is what he's in. He's in this thing, which is either got green screens in it or is designed, you know, outfitted to look like his stupid plane. It does this parabolic arc and they get about 20 to 40 seconds of weightlessness. So these are people in a zero G plane floating around. That's all they did. And then they land his plane. He gets out. He interviews with the press and he's lying. He's absolutely lying. And I'm going to prove it. I'm going to show you a launch that just show you how ridiculous it is. This is Jeff Bezos with his, what does that look like? Okay. And look at the motion. They always have this jerking motion. What's going on here? Okay.
The penis.
It's a ridiculous. And where's the smoke trail? You know how sometimes they have smoke trails, sometimes they don't. What are they using? Different fuels?
And this the answer, mocking.
They're mocking us. It's mocking us. And if you look at the Virgin, you know, plane rocket, it looks like, turn it upside down, it looks like a uterus and a vagina. And then you have the Blue Origin that is a penis, okay? Mm-hmm. They love their sexual innuendos.
You're doing it clearly, clearly looks like that.
All right. And so let me show you a rocket launch. And you tell me if this is a real rocket launch or a fake rocket launch. If I could find it, I would love to show it to you. Here we go. Is this a real rocket launch? Now, this thing weighs, I don't know, a couple million pounds. It's gigantic. Okay. And this thing's going to go up into space, and then it's going to free fall back to Earth, and it's going to land upright. First, that thrust from that little flame, does that look like it's lifting up millions of pounds? And now watch. See how the angle from the camera is kind of at a 45-degree angle, right? Now look how high it is. How do they have this side shot still going, right? And look at this thing. How come it's not shooting up? How did it get this high? And now look at it. Now watch. Now it's free falling. It's at least 40,000 pounds. Free falling. Now look at the smoke coming off of it. Watch how look how slow. Watch the next shot. Look at the smoke. It's barely moving. Is this free falling? Absolutely not. Free falling, it would be going 1,000 miles an hour. Oh, look how high it is all of a sudden now. This is done in real time. I did not edit this. Okay, now watch this thing. It's going to go on, it's going to turn upright, two of the engines are going to go out, and then it's going to land upright with a whole bunch of CGI smoke. Okay, watch.
So this
And
is
then
all they don't even do.
this is what they showed us as real. Look, now watch. All of a sudden, there's a camera underneath it. Well, where did that camera come from? Two of the engines are going to go out. You got all this flame and smoke. Look how you can see how fast it's moving. It's barely moving at all. And then it's going to land. Watch the smoke. Look at that. That's CGI smoke. That's so easy to make. Just look up CGI smoke. It looks just like that. And then this thing lands, and people believe this. Here's what I say. If you just watch that and you believe that's real, you're never going to see the reality of this world. So there you go. And then this is them landing on Mars. This is the Chinese landing on Mars. Look at this. This is the only proof that the Chinese landed on Mars. Who filmed it? Where did look at that shadow. Look at this. That's Mars, supposedly. You could
So
do that.
the theory is that all of these people know that this is fake, but they are still
All of what people?
like all of the actors.
Yes.
Or the theory is that all of these people are actors and they're all agreeing to never tell these secrets. They're just pretending
Possibly,
to.
except Don Pettit. He
All of
might
these girls.
just be retarded and not know. Okay? So
Okay.
they all know.
Oh.
If you look at the moon landing when the guys came back, first guys went to the moon, they did, it's unbelievable. They should be more pumped than anybody was, but they're being forced to lie. And if you watch their press conference, they're being forced to lie and they can't even get their story straight, right?
Okay.
So look at these guys. This is Chris Hadfield, and you got this guy with his microphone. They're in different green screen rooms, and this Chris is playing his guitar, and the guy with the microphone misplaces where he's supposed to put the microphone, and he sticks it right into his neck. Look, it's inside his neck because it's green screened. Okay? So
Oh,
it's inside his neck.
wow.
There's many times where all different stuff happens, where their heads get chopped off, where they get tangled in their wires, right? These guys, look at these guys. Why do they have big utility belts? Are their pants going to fall down in zero gravity? Look, what's underneath those pants? Are they wearing diapers? They're wearing waist harnesses, okay? They're trying to hold themselves upright,
This
okay?
looks really fake. I'm
This
not
is
gonna lie.
from the space station, okay? Right? And
Yeah.
sometimes they use real objects. Sometimes they use CGI objects. This is a ball and it has helium in it, but he squeezed some of the helium out. This guy tries to pick it up and his wires won't let him go there. They're all standing there. They got all nervous, right? Look at the girl. She's like, no, don't go. Don't do it. And we catch them in doing these fake things all the time. Watch this guy's head. It's transparent right there. Transparent. He's being faded into the scene. All right? All of this stuff here. Watch this lemon. They got a lemon and they're playing with it. Watch the lemon. It goes right through his hand. Okay? It's not a real lemon. It's called augmented reality. It's where they're manipulating CGI objects in real time, and they're manipulating them in real time, and you can't see them. Look right here. Is there anything there? Now, bam. There's a stuffed animal and she's playing with it. It's not
What the
really
hell?
there. It's not really there. This is real. It's filled with helium. This is a stuffed, this is a, it's called Leap Motion Augmented Reality, and she's manipulating stuff, and she probably has contacts on, or there's a screen behind the camera, and she can see where things are, and they can move them, just like in the movie Gravity, you know, where they're doing stuff. It's all done in a green screen room. This is all done with green screens. Do you know that they have the space shuttle, the International Space Station, or I call the International Fake Station, is there's a buoy, there's a the National Buoyancy Lab, where they have a mockery mock up of it in a giant pool with green screens. Okay, why do they have that? Right, their spacewalks are done in pools, and many times we catch them with bubbles coming up from their, you know, from like a crease or something, because they're in a pool. And NASA's like, oh, you know, we don't know, that's a paint fleck or a piece of ice or whatever. And you know, we've had flat earthers go into when they're doing presentations and do Q&A and ask them about this bubble. He's like, I don't know what you're talking about. And then he's like, oh, well, you know, it's this, it's that. And then he confronts him again at another time, and he's like, oh, I've never heard of that, right? Because they don't know what to say, because there is no answer. Okay, none of this is real. Okay, do you think they could fake the space station? None of this, right? And they, in real time, they could edit things out. They could edit things out that are there, you know. So when they got scuba divers helping them, handing them tools and whatnot, this is the, you know, this is not there. Look, it's not there, and this is done live, right? So they can do anything. Here's a space station in a swimming pool. You got this, which is a Vitruvian man being handed a power tool by a scuba diver, and it's hard to see, but there's a rocket trying to break through a dome here. All right?
Oh, that's where is that?
That's at their warehouse
What the
training
hell?
facility. Right.
That's what I thought.
It's unreal how much crap they have. Unreal. And
So
they're always telling us, look, pool, green screens, this is what they show us.
the Earth, what would it be resting on, right? Because if it's flat and there's no gravity, then where are we and what the hell is this?
So the only thing that we can truthfully say about anything beyond the shoreline of Antarctica or over as high as we can reach is we don't know. We don't know, but we can surely speculate. You know, if you look at biblical texts and whatnot, they say it's resting on a. Here's the thing. I don't know what's below us. The deepest hole ever dug is less than 8 miles, right? Less than 8 miles, which is like halfway through the skin of an apple as comparison, right? And so when they did that, they dug this hole. It's called the Great Borehole. This may or may not be the exact hole, but they dug a hole just short of 8 miles in Russia. And they were using ground penetrating radar to see what they were going to hit next, and they were wrong every step of the way. They were wrong. Think about this. They're using ground penetrating radar. They're wrong. Like, up, there's no more water. They hit water. Up, there's no more rocks. They hit rocks. They were wrong. So it's useless. They should get their money back on that. But then they hit an impenetrable barrier that they try for years to drill through to blow up. They cannot get through it. And then they go, well, we know what the next 4,000 miles is. We can tell you all the layers below us, right? This is pseudoscience. A molten magnetic core is a scientific impossibility because magnets lose their magnetism when they get hot.
So, do you have an image you'd be able to pull up on what the Earth looks, what it would make sense to you, what it would actually look like?
Here's a
Okay.
possibility. We live here on the Earth plane. This is our oceans. We can circumnavigate west or east. The east and west are circles. If you don't understand that, I'll show you in a second. And then here's Antarctica. Here's the North Pole in the middle. And maybe beyond Antarctica, there's more land. Maybe there's more continents out here. Okay, so if we let me ask you a question. Let's see if you get this. Nobody gets it. I lead them right into it, and they nobody gets it. If we lived
Okay.
here on this map in this inner space, and this is where there's extra territory, what would you call somebody that lives on the extra territory?
extraterrestrials.
And w if they came to visit us, where would they be coming from if this is the interspace?
Outer space. Did you come up with that yourself?
I don't know if I did or didn't.
That's very
I'll give
clever.
credit to whoever did if I didn't.
That's very clever for sure.
All right. And so, but by the way, it's not that clever. It's not that clever because they're always telling us what to do. Let me share my screen real quick. So do you understand how east and west are circles? Do you want me to show you? I'll show you.
Yeah,
Here's a
yeah.
magnetic center. Do you know how a compass works, right? The compass always points towards the magnet. So west on the compass is right here, okay? So I'm trying to push that west, but I have to keep that needle pointed towards the center. So west is a circle. West is not a straight line. And if I want to go east, east is right here on the compass. Well, that compass keeps making me turn because that north has to always stay pointing towards the north. So west and east are circles. Now watch what happens when I try to dead reckon west. Dead reckons mean I'm not going to correct to the north. And as soon as I start moving, I'm heading south. All of these lines away from north are south. South is every direction away from the north, right? So east and west are circles on a map, on a flat Earth and a globe Earth. Okay? So here's how our Earth works. Excuse me. The sun goes around in circles. It's traveling to the west. We see it rise in the east and set in the west because that's how it's going, right? I'm here in Connecticut, right? The sun will rise over here and set over here. So now it's noon in Australia, okay? Wherever the sun is, it's noon. They go,
So all day circles like that.
say again.
So all day long it just circles
It
like
circles,
that.
and when it gets far enough away from us, its light can no longer push through the thickness of the atmosphere, and it's nighttime. Its light is fluorescing the molecules in the air, giving us daylight, which is different than sunlight. Sunlight is the sun that you see. Daylight is the blue sky. When the sun, even before the sun rises in the morning, there's daylight. The sky is fluorescing like a Tesla coil would fluoresce fluorescent bulbs. And most of the upper atmosphere is nitrogen. And when you put nitrogen in a bulb and fluoresce it, it's blue.
So how do seasons work?
Thanks for asking at this point, because this is the perfect screen to show you. So if you and I were standing outside 20 feet apart, it's the middle of winter, it's freezing. And somebody held a nice big heat lamp 10 feet directly over your head, and you could feel the heat. Pretend that's your summer sun. Where is it? It's high in the sky for you. Okay? Right? It's high in the sky. It's over your head. It's close, and you could feel it. All right? I'm looking at that sun, and it's over there. It's lower in the sky for me, and I could barely feel the heat. That's my winter sun. And if that person walked that light, keeping it at the same height, and brought it over to me, you would watch it get lower in the sky and farther away. I'd watch it rise in the sky and get closer. That's my summer sun. So right here, the inside circle is the Tropic of Cancer. The outside yellow circle is the Tropic of Capricorn. Let's jump forward 2 months to December. And in December, the sun is over the Tropic of Capricorn. The sun is high in the sky over Australia. It's their summer. And it's cold for us because it's far away. When the sun comes around, it comes around down here where my mouse is, and it's farther away from us. Therefore, it's like that heat lamp. It's lower in the sky. It's farther away. I can't feel the heat. And I have a shorter day because it's not that high in the sky and it disappears because it's farther away, right? So right here, I'm on the East Coast, sunrise. The sun is approaching. It's getting higher in the sky, but it's still far away. If I go 6 months, oops. If I go 6 months to June, May, June, it's now over Miami. It's over Southern California and Mexico. It's high in the sky for them. It's their summer. It's Santiago's winter. It's northern, it's southern. Southern Africa's winter. It's Australia's winter because the sun is farther away. lower in the sky. That's how seasons work.
But
if you're unsure how seasons work and you want more information, see this question mark? Hit that question mark and up comes all of these questions. What about seasons right there? Click that puppy. Up comes, hit open YouTube, and up comes a playlist of videos that they don't want us to see that will explain seasons better than I just did with more information. And then you can take all of that and figure it out on your own.
Excellent. Yeah, I definitely will dig into that for sure.
And just so, one quick thing while we're here. There's flat earthers everywhere. These are all the flat earthers that are just near me. Okay. And you can message them on this app. Tap on any blue dot and you can send that person a message and you can meet people that way. You can find people to work for you, work for people. It's going to be all sorts of stuff, but it's a great tool to connect with other flat earthers.
Well, I feel like you can do a whole show just based off of living with being a flat earther and all that comes with, because sure. It's kind of, do you feel like that's isolating?
Well, it used to be isolating, but not for me, because I've embraced it and I've made it the part of my life. I walked away from my own company just to talk about flat earth, to talk to people like you, talk to people that think flat earth is the dumbest thing ever. You're halfway there. Your brother is already showing you stuff. But as you said in the very beginning, you haven't taken the time to look in, because belief is easy. You can believe we live on a ball. You have nothing else to do. All right. You're done. Hey, we live on a ball. Okay, thanks. I'm going to go take a nap. I'm going to go party with my friends, whatever. But if you want to know that we live on a ball, you have to actually look into it. And if you do, you're screwed, because you realize the heliocentric ball model is literally the dumbest thing on the earth plane.
Well, I feel like it's actually way scarier to think that you're floating in space on this
Wait.
Circle.
So here's the story that they want you to believe, that nothing exploded and it turned into everything. That's fun. Okay. Nothing turns into everything. Okay. And then all of the rocky bits turned into balls and all of the gases turned into bigger balls, burst into flames, left a vacuum in between. That's a problem. Okay. Vacuum in space. And then they all started going into perfect orbits, not like a beehive, like a fucking clock. Okay. Because if you go out tonight and look at all the stars in the sky and make a little map, next year, 10 years, same night, same time, go out. Every star will be in the exact same position. Is that like a clock or like a beehive?
Clock. It's, I don't know.
It's like a clock.
It's like a clock. Yes.
Very good. Okay. So all of our eclipses repeat every 18 years. The idea of a heliocentric eclipse with the sun 400 times bigger and 400 times farther than the moon and them lining up perfectly is one in a quadrillion quadrillions. Okay. But it happens every year and at the end and in different cycles. And at the end of that 18 years, the whole cycles repeat again. Does that sound like a clock or a beehive? A clock.
I don't know. A clock.
Okay. Very good.
I'm going to have to watch all of this, to be completely honest, and like take notes.
Listen, here's the thing. We take care of our bodies. We work out. We eat good food. We do stuff. Mental exercise. This is mental exercise. They never taught us to do it. This is what they want us doing. They teach us algebra and geometry and accounting so we can be good slaves. They don't teach us vortex mathematics and sacred geometry, right? They teach us to, all right, now we need to make you feel like a winner. So here's a sports team, giant stadium, and then your team can win. You've now have victory. So now you're fulfilled in the we won department. You've expended all your energy. Here's plenty of alcohol, okay? Drink yourselves silly. Work the majority of your lives in something you hate doing and realize that there's nothing else to discover, because we discovered it all, right? Because we live on a ball and we're running out of resources. We're running out of food. Impossible. Running out of water. Impossible. There's infinite water. We're running out of space. Impossible. Every family could have a quarter acre in Texas on the entire world. Okay. If there's as many people as they say there are. Every single thing that they tell us, everything that they have us being afraid of, is to limit our ability to manifest the world that we want.
Okay, so, and I love the concept of aliens. I know that Elon Musk actually said on a Joe Rogan podcast he didn't believe in aliens, that that was a thing. So you think that the aliens would be the outer spacers, right? The people.
Let me ask you a question. And this is, your mind is going to melt. I'm going to tell you already, but I'm going to keep it as simple as possible. The closest star is 25 trillion miles away. You can't fathom what 25 trillion miles is, okay? Let's fathom what a trillion is. I'll give you 10 bitcoins if you tell me how long 1 trillion seconds is. And don't say 1 trillion seconds. How many days is 1 trillion seconds? If you get it within 5 days, I'll give you 10 bitcoins. How long is 1 trillion seconds?
Oh gosh. I don't know, like a 10 years, I
Very close,
don't
very close. 31,000 years, okay?
Very close.
31,000 years, okay? And the closest star is 25 trillion miles away. And maybe there's a planet around it. Maybe there's intelligent life there that learned to transverse that intergalactic empty space, come here and crash in Roswell, New Mexico. Or is it possible that there's people just a couple thousand miles away beyond Antarctica that could fly here on a conventional aircraft, then crash in Roswell, or an advanced aircraft? Maybe I believe that the people that live in the outer space here on the Earth plane have advanced technology. They have free energy technology, which was stolen from us in the late 1800s. Okay,
Oh,
this
so that's
world,
interesting.
yeah.
So you
So
think that those people are more the elite?
I think that that's where the true rulers of this world are. They're in lands that we don't have access to. They're in Antarctica or beyond Antarctica, and who knows what's out there. But, again, we don't have any proof of this. There could be nothing beyond our world. Maybe Antarctica and the dome terminate, and that's the end of it, and we're in God's snow globe. I don't believe that we're in a snow globe like this shows. I believe that the sky is almost flat above us. Whether there's a solid barrier or not, I don't know. I mean, you need a container to have gas pressure. Well, we have gas pressure on Earth, so there must be some sort of container. But if you think about a bubble on you're boiling a pot of water and you look at the bubble, if you were inside that bubble, you're standing on a flat surface, you have a dome over you and there's water is above you, but there's really no barrier other than air pressure. The container of the bubble. So maybe our firmament is just frozen air, frozen. Maybe it's glass. Maybe it's, who knows what it is? I'm not claiming to know. I'm not claiming that there is a dome. But if you ask me, you said, "Hey Dave, we know the answer. If you guess it right, you win." I'm gonna say there's a physical dome that is solid. That's my opinion.
That's really interesting. Do any weird things ever happen to you because you are bringing attention to this?
Nothing like that, but weird things happen to me every day, but not because of that. I mean, the world is so screwed. The world is so crazy. Oh, I meant to finish my point before, where they don't teach us what to learn in school. They teach us, we get our win with our sports teams, and then they tell us, oh, what the, I just lost it again. See, there's something weird. I had a great point to
It'll
make, and
come
now
back.
it's gone. Now it's gone.
Yeah.
It'll come back.
Okay. So, are there any other conspiracies that you believe in? And I don't mean to call this like a conspiracy because it is very logical. But is there
Are you
anything else?
asking if there's other times where elite people have done things to conspire against us for their own gain and benefit? Yes. Yes. Yeah.
Do you believe in astrology?
So astrology, I used to laugh at astrology. How is Mars being in retrograde? It's 25 million miles away. How's that going to affect my life? It can't even affect the tides because I believe that gravity affected tides, and that's not the case. And then I realized, wow, the Earth is flat. Everything we see in the sky is within the Earth system. Mars is not a rock floating in space. It's more of a sentient, energetic body named after a god. Okay, so okay, maybe that would affect my life. All right, maybe if we look, this is Mars. Okay, this is what Mars is. Mars isn't what they show us. What NASA shows us, right? That's nonsense, right? When they show us pictures of Mars, They showed us this. Look, the rover got this, and you could tell it's the rover because this is in the corner, and this is impossible to fake. You could never fake this. But here's a shot on Devon Island. It's the same hill with the same rocks and the same path. Okay? NASA's website. Greenland.
Oh, wow. I'm really glad that you showed that. That's really cool.
Yeah. And then, wow. You know, and then they show us Earth. This makes no sense. If this was accurate of the Earth, I should be able to fit 8.5 of these between the diameter of the Earth. Because they tell us this is the diameter. This we can actually physically measure. So we take this block. I should fit 8.5 of those in there. I could barely fit 3.5. This is a painting. This is a painting. And guess what? NASA admits there are no photographs of Earth. Only globe believers who have no idea what their model is, who have the misconception of what the flat Earth is, they claim that the photos are real because they've done no research, right? They believe, nobody knows the Earth is a globe. They just believe it. Flat Earth, there's no 100% for sure that we're not on a globe. Now, I didn't say we didn't know it's flat. I'd bet my life that it's flat. But this whole realm that we live on, I don't know what's below it, what's beyond it. Do we live on an infinite plane, an extended plane, a limited plane? I don't know. If you ask me, I think there's infinite more land and infinite more worlds beyond us on this plane. Why are all of the telescopes in southern, the telescopes, by the way, are also owned by the Vatican, but they're all like in Australia, New Zealand, Santiago. They're all out here and they're not looking up into the sky. They're all looking out. They're all looking across the plane. Why are they all looking south? Okay.
Yeah.
They're not pointed up. They're pointed out. What are they looking at? What are they looking at? Amelia Earhart, by the way, she circumnavigated the Earth. Remember I showed you? She either went east or west, just did a nice little circle around the lake. And when you get to the edge of the lake, you don't fall off because there's land. What's beyond there? Don't know. It's off limits.
So that actually, I wasn't sure if it was a dumb question, but now that you say that.
Every question is a dumb question. Go ahead.
Yeah. But like the pilots, like wouldn't they know that the Earth is flat? If it was?
They're very good. Yes, most of them do. Most pilots take off and land the plane. But when they're flying, air controller says, see, you know, the knob over, so turn that to 760. So he turns it to 760, he presses it, and the pilot and the plane flies itself. All right, now adjust to 529. 529 hits it, the plane adjusts and goes. They're not flying, they're not looking. They're reading books and playing cards, okay? And when they look out, they see a flat level plane, but they just think the Earth is so big that they don't see it. But what they don't realize is that the Earth, at the height that they're flying, the ground should be 70, the horizon should be 78,000 feet below them. Okay? At the height that they're flying, the horizon should drop off 78,000 feet. Again, 78,000 feet is so high, you can't fathom it. But if they look out the left window and look out the right window, they're going to see the horizon at eye level, draw a line. It goes right between their eyes. And that should be 78,000 feet below them. It's ridiculous. Yeah. Absolute ridiculous. And here's something. The if you look at the plane flights, right? If you want to fly from, what does it say, Argentina? That's covered. Argentina to India, you go all the way up here. What happened to flying across here? Well, look at it on a flat Earth map. It's kind of like a straight line, right? If you want to go from Buenos Aires to Johannesburg, they go all the way up here. What happened to this 5,000 mile little short trek here? Okay, right? So they go all the way up. Many of these southern flights cross the equator, okay? Southern location to southern locations, most often cross the equator. Why do they go all the way into the north, right? Why do they go all the way in the north? But never, ever, ever does a northern flight cross the equator during its trip and go into the southern hemisphere. Okay, here's a northern flight had an emergency landing and it landed in Calgary, which is way out of the way. Like it had the it landed here because there's an emergency, so it flew all the way to there. And the reason is because Calgary is right on that line, a straight line. Do you get it? Do you see
it? That's really fascinating.
So again, Hawaii to New York, emergency landing in Seattle. Seattle's over here. Why the hell would they go to Seattle? Why wouldn't they land in California or anywhere along this line, right? Well, they are landing along that line. So here's the thing. So let's say on a ball, you have equal latitudes north and south. So let's take, this is 5,000 miles apart, and these airports are at whatever southern latitude. Find two northern latitudes, two airports, northern latitudes that are at the same equal northern latitude, 5,000 miles apart, and watch their flight plan. It doesn't go all the way down and back up. It just goes beep, beep, right across the center. It never crosses the equator. Because look, here's how the Earth is laid out. So everything outside of this line is the southern hemisphere or the southern outer world. And everything inside the circle is the inner northern world. So you can just play a game. You got two pins and stick them any two places inside the circle and draw a line between them. That line will never cross the red line, right? Any two pinpoints inside this circle, northern locations, you can fly a plane directly between them without ever crossing this red line, without exception, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Now, do the same out here. Put a pin here and put a pin here. You're going to cross into the northern hemisphere to get there. Put a pin, you know, here, like Buenos Aires right here, and put a pin over here. Okay, or over here, you're going to cross into the north, okay? And again, our map probably isn't perfect. We've only been at this for like 6 years. But here's the thing.
Mm-hmm.
People haven't known the Earth is a globe for 2,000 years like they tell us. That's a lie. It's less than 100 years old. Did you see my interview with Ruth? Probably not.
No, I don't think so. No.
So Ruth is 102-year-old woman interviewing her about the world's fairs, and she had such a great memory. I said, hey, what did they teach you in elementary school about the Earth? That's all I said. Never mentioned flat Earth. And she goes, they taught me the Earth was flat. This is in public school in Connecticut in the 1920s. They were teaching flat Earth in Croatia. We found a woman that said they were teaching it in all of the schools through the 1930s. Okay.
So this is a brand new thing.
Less than 100 years old, and they've lied to us about our history. They're like, what about Copernicus and Pythagoras and Galileo and all of these guys? These guys are all Freemasons. I don't even think most of them were real. I think they're just made up characters on the world stage. When you look at the stories of Aristophanes with his sticks and shadows, it doesn't line up. It makes no sense. Here, these guys are all Freemasons. I don't believe they existed. I don't believe any of them existed. I think they're made up stories. In the 1800s, there was an advanced worldwide civilization here that makes us look like we're in the middle of the movie Idiocracy. Okay? Oh, that's what I was going to say. Oh, it's gone again. It's gone again.
This
it's like they get us with movies. I think that's what it was. They get us with movies. You know, we spend our energy on sports and we work all day and we drink and we've got our victory with the sports. And now we watch a movie to control our mind. Hollywood. What is a wizard's stick made out of? What kind of wood? A wizard's wand. What kind of wood? It's made from the holly tree.
Oh, okay.
Hollywood. Is a wizard's wand.
You okay, yes.
Hollywood.
Yes, I'm with you now. It took
Hollywood.
A second.
Mm-hmm. Hollywood. All right, and you know the difference between the... go ahead, you first, and then I want to tell you the difference between the Arctic and the Antarctic.
I've heard a lot... Yeah, I definitely want to hear about that. I've heard a lot about the Freemasons, which is really fascinating to me because my great-grandfather and even my... own dad and like my grandma and my aunt was like kind of a part of it when they were kids and stuff. But my great grandfather was like really high up in the Freemasons. So what's like the whole theory with all of this?
The way I see the Freemasons is a lot of people get into the Freemasons innocently and because they're good people and they want to do good things, and they do good things. But then you get promoted higher and higher and higher, but they'll never promote anybody into the 33rd degree or whatever it is, unless they're compromised, unless they're willing to play a game, unless they have dirt on them, unless they're completely and totally compromised. Then they get them up there and they're compromised. They're like, hey, you want to come to the next level? Here, do this horrible, disgusting thing and let us film it. Okay, now you're in the next level. And now they can never come out. It's like, oh, since you're here, don't worry about that. We're never going to show that. Here, sleep with this girl and do this thing and do all these, and just have a good time. And we're going to give you money and we're giving you power. And you're just going to vote this way whenever it comes time to vote. Totally controlled, right? That's what it's all about. That's how the Tower of Control goes. So the Freemasons know the truth of our world. I actually literally before the show, I just started my own Telegram channel. It's called the Flat Earth Clock, the Flat Earth Sun, Moon, and Zodiac Clock app channel. And I'm going to be uploading all the many of the videos that I load up on the app. So they're there, they're easy to find, and when YouTube explodes, they'll still be there. But the first video I uploaded was a Freemason showing us how the world really works, which is literally beyond my ability to fully understand. Talks about a black sun under the earth and reflections and the moons and the polarity. And I highly recommend people find that Telegram and go to the very first video. And it's a guy in front of a whiteboard. He doesn't show his face and he doesn't talk, so he can't be identified. And he basically draws out the whole thing and is mind blowing.
Would you be able to actually link that for me as well? Because
I will send
I
you
want.
it's t.me/ flat earth
Perfect.
clock, the flat earth sun, moon, and zodiac clock app. But I'll send you an email with a
Definitely
link
want
to
to
that.
see that.
All right, so
Definitely
just
want to.
real quick on the on whoops on the flat earth sun, moon, and zodiac clock app. So the inner north is where we live, right? You with me?
Yes, right.
So I got the sun whizzing around. So in the middle, we live here. So the inner north, everything inside of this yellow circle is called the Arctic region because we're near the Arctic. And anything outside of this yellow circle is the Antarctic region. Okay? Well, if we lived on a ball, why would they call it the Arctic and the Antarctic? Well, let's look at this. If you're on the inside, what's the sun doing? What's the sun doing? Is it going in a straight line by me? Is it arcing around me? What is it doing?
Yeah,
It's arcing around me.
yeah.
What about out here? Is it arcing around me? If I'm out here, is the sun arcing around me? No, it's antarcting. It's coming towards me and then going away. It never goes around me. It's the Antarctic. They're telling us the Earth is flat, the Arctic and the Antarctic.
Wow.
Yeah, do you see it now?
Definitely.
You're gonna be smarter than your brother soon.
Yeah, he's super excited about this for sure, because he's been the only one in the family. I'm definitely more convinced than I was
Here's the
when
thing. When I started this 5 years, 6 years ago, 2015-ish. It was brutal. You mentioned flat Earth, you get laughed at, ridiculed, people get upset, just everything. Now
Yeah.
you mention flat Earth, people are like, I heard something about that. Can you tell me something? You tell me this? Can you tell me that? Can you explain
Yeah.
this? And now people are listening. Now it's friggin' easy. Now it's just easy because everybody is waking up to it, and we're gonna see what they do to try to stop that. But here's what I say. Sometimes when I would be on a show that doesn't know who I am, they'd say, tell me about yourself. And I'd say, well, I grew up here, I went to college, and I went to medical school. And in the fourth year of medical school, I really realized allopathic medicine was nonsense. And I dropped out and I followed a more holistic route. And then I went in, blah, 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 blah. And I'm here and here and here. And then, like 3 minutes later, I talk about how belief is the enemy of knowing. Belief is easy, as I said. Knowing takes time, effort, and thought. I said, for
Yeah.
example, you guys believe I went to medical school. I didn't. Now I'm telling this story for a reason. I didn't. And during that gap from when I told them that and from when I revealed that I was lying, I felt like shit. Okay, even though I was using it as an example, I wasn't really deceiving them, but I was deceiving them. I was standing in a lie and I didn't like it. The energy of just deceiving somebody, even for a point, sucks. So once you see truth, you need to stand in your truth. You need to stand in it and you need to sing it out loud because there's no time left, right? Now, there are many people that are not here to wake up. Don't sing it to them. Stand in your truth. If somebody doesn't want to hear it, that's their choice. It's not your job to wake them up. But if somebody does want to hear it is your job to offer what you know and allow them to make up their own minds. You need to stand in your truth. Because if you stand in your truth, this earth system, not soul lure system, the one that's trying to steal your soul, this earth system will deliver you your greatest wishes.
So, in closing, after, you have a lot more knowing than I do. I have a lot of work to do. That's why I'm excited about those links that you're going to be providing us, because I'm definitely going to dive into those. But from all that you know about this, what would you suggest for the people who are, just starting out to do daily in order to be an asset?
You're like the best interviewer I've had because you're asking all of the right questions. So if you Google flat, hey, those guys are making some interesting points. Let me go on YouTube and Google flat Earth proof, top 10 proofs. You're gonna get garbage. You're gonna get the propaganda. You're gonna get Psyop Man
Right.
Dan. You're gonna get Professor Dave. The number one video you'll get is Professor Dave. It's not Professor Dave. It's actor Dave strawmanning us and gaslighting us with nonsensical, snarky arguments. Okay, you're gonna get tired. You're gonna give up. You Google it. You're gonna end up at the Flat Earth Society. That's not us. The Flat Earth Society is a government-run disinformation site. So what is the trick? The trick is my app. Oh, he's here selling apps. No, oh, I'm here giving you a tool. It's $3, okay? You have it for life, right? And every day on the app, there's a featured video, okay? Let me show you. Every day on the app comes a where is it? Am I up? There it goes. Every day on the bottom left, there's a featured video. Today is an awesome one because just recently there was this Qantas flight Q14 that supposedly proves that the Earth is a ball, but we looked at the data and we're showing you exactly how it actually proves the Earth is flat. Every proof they try to give us to prove the ball actually proves flat Earth. So you click on that thumbnail every day. Here's the thing. If you don't believe it, great. Every morning at breakfast, when you get up, whatever, end of the day. Click that video, watch it every day. I have a 3 Bitcoin challenge. 3 Bitcoins for anybody that can give me one proof of the globe, but you have to watch the video every day. Excuse me. Every day for 2 weeks. Short videos during the week, longer ones on the weekends. And if you miss any, you can just click that video archive button, which is right next to it, and you could start watching all of them. So let me tell you what happens. People say, all right, I'm going to do this. I'm going to take the challenge. I'm going to click that video. And then, like, that was pretty good. And then they're going to watch the next video. Well, the next video is a video that I selected, not a video that YouTube selected. Okay. Then they're going to go, well, what about when the boats go over the horizon? Well, you hit the question mark. You go, ships over the horizon. Up comes a playlist of videos that YouTube doesn't want you to see. Videos that I don't want to make prove you anything. I want to show you how you can go out and do this yourself. Okay? Tons of videos that prove the Earth is not a globe, and they're all there. And that's it. All you need to do is get the app. And there's tons of resources. If you want to learn more about our history, up here, The Lost History of Flat Earth, that one will blow you away. It's 5 hours long, and I can guarantee you one thing. If you turn it on, you won't turn it off. And when you're done, you're going to watch it again. Okay? All sorts of stuff. Or if you're a reader, I got books, right? These are all books, right? All sorts of stuff. And then you can scroll down. There's actually more stuff. Full-length videos, right? Globusters 24/7. Instead of letting CNN run, right, let Globusters run, right? It's all clips of videos, shorts videos, all sorts of stuff. And just let that run in the background, and it's fascinating. Fascinating. fascinating stuff. It'll blow your mind. And here's the other thing, and ask your brother this. Since he's become a flat earther, ask him the last time he was bored, and the answer will be never. Never.
What is that?
You're never bored when you're a flat earther because there's always something new
bored.
To learn.
Bored. I thought you bored. Born.
No, bored. Bored. No, he was never born. Well, you know, that John, I was at John Wick or whoever, the guy without a belly button. You're never bored. Never, bored. Never bored.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's something I always say is I'm always like, this world is so boring. So I'm glad I got
It's not
now.
Boring. You know what's boring? Netflix is boring. Look out the window. The world is way more insane than that. I mean, Black Mirror, that's reality now, all right? And Netflix is programming your mind to create the world that they want. They want you focusing on all of this negative stuff. They're programming you because our minds create the reality around us. So they're trying to get us all thinking about the same thing. They do these mass ritual events like the thing that happened in September in New York City. And we're all focusing on that. And all these wars started on this ridiculous event. Ridiculous. Okay? So they want us in fear. They want us not communicating with each other, not seeing each other's faces. Imagine if I did this whole thing like this and you couldn't see my facial expressions the whole time or basically hear me, right? It would suck, right? They don't want us seeing micro expressions. They don't want us seeing a smile. They literally want us separated. You know, if you don't see smiles long enough, you're going to get sick and die. You know that? Mm-hmm. If you watch CNN, you're going to get sick and die. Okay. Mm-hmm. All of this stuff causes discord in the body. Okay. Mm-hmm. So that's where we're at.
I completely 1000% agree. Well, this turned into from being a very upsetting topic to now I'm actually feeling very hopeful. So thank you for
Tell your brother to gift you the app, okay? Make him buy it for you. It's $3, okay? Tell him to gift and tell him the fact that he hasn't gifted it to you already is a problem, okay? Him and I are gonna go at it.
Yeah.
Right? Is he going to Flattoberfest?
Where is that?
It's in South Carolina on next weekend. The following weekend,
really?
October 23rd and 24th. You should go. People are driving 15, 20 hours. People are driving from Denver. I'm driving 13 hours from Connecticut. It's amazing. To have your brother. It's called Flattoberfest. Flatearthfestivals.com. It's also in the app. Just hit the shopping cart button and all of the links in there. It's the number one link. Flatearthfestivals.com. It's amazing. Amazing.
He is a very dedicated father, so he won't miss like one single soccer game that his kids have, but I'll definitely try to get him to go. That would be amazing.
All right, or go without him. Go without him. You'll have hundreds and hundreds of new best friends.
Yeah.
That's what happens at Flattoberfest.
Yeah. Well, I think that's one of the most powerful things we can do is support each other.
100%. All right.
Well, thank you so much, Dave.
All right, thanks.
You all love the Flat Earth Sun, Moon, and Zodiac Clock app, the best tool to show your friends and strangers how the Flat Earth actually works. But are you ready for a Flat Earth app game changer? A new feature has been added. But first, a reminder of some of the existing features. Video of the day. World time. See what time it is all around the Flat Earth. A true Earth compass that shows true navigation across and around the Flat Earth plane. Weather. Tap for detailed local weather information. Know what phase and where the moon is at all times. Watch the sun travel between the tropics for the seasons. Select an amazing background. Add a countdown to your next big date. Video playlists in different languages. See the real trade winds circling the flat earth. Top 21 frequently asked questions with quick pop-up video answers. Access to the best photos and gifts at your fingertips. Flat Earth books and merchandise and more. Now, the game changer upgrade we've always dreamed of having. After a year in development, our app just went next level. You're now able to find Flat Earth app users near you. See where they are and send them an instant message in the app. Instantly arrange for a Flat Earther meetup. When activated, blue dots mark the location of the app users near you. You have three choices on showing your location. PP, to pinpoint. This marks your exact location. CC, for city center, which will place you within a few miles of your current location. Or turn off, which removes you from the map altogether. Use it when traveling, or when you're out for a day at the beach, or while eating out somewhere. Find out where other Flat Earthers are and connect. Find like-minded Flat Earth app users and regain your sanity. The Flat Earth Sun, Moon, and Zodiac Clock app is the best tool to show your friends and strangers how our Flat Earth actually works.